John, apparently I thought that was going to be a lift-off in this game. You could go on and win it from there.
Yeah, just chatting to a member of staff, you know, we've consistently missed pens this year. You know, you're looking at Smuts and Smuts have took the bottle to take it. My looking looked, you know, didn't look a good pen in a way. And he was so much in the ascendancy at the time. And it's one where, you know, I've challenged the boys at half time to go and win the game. And I think what you've seen then is, you know, the intent and the purpose of the play, especially for the fans turning up. There's a big number of our fans come all the way down.
74,
fantastic. You know, as we said, we wanted to lay one on for the fans because we've had a decent away record. And I thought you'd seen that second half. First half was a little bit, started well, they got back into the game. But I thought second half was really on the ascendancy. The penalty changes things.
Yeah, it's a brave penalty in some ways to go down the middle, but maybe it just lacked a little bit of elevation to get over the legs.
Possibly, yeah, possibly. But it's a miss.
The funny thing was that Junior gave you his obvious brother penalty. I'd seen him take a penalty earlier in the season against Coventry City. Was any thought that he might take the spot?
Well, I think he's gone for the ball as well, but Sam's our penalty taker. I think we've made that clear throughout the season. I think one of two questions got asked when Mika took it. But we've had four penalties this season. I think it's great, as you were saying, it was 4-7. I think the numbers were there. All important parts of the game where we should be then taking the game and going and possibly hitting him on the counter, because I thought, you know, Ryan Gondo making his debut, I thought has an excellent debut. Courtney was in and out at times with short glimpses. I thought Junior come on and put himself about, and he was a bit of a difference, I thought, second half.